Welcome all of you. Today we are going to discuss about AC circuit containing pure inductance. Let's see here. Let an alternating EMF E is equals to E0 sine omega t be applied to a circuit with a pure inductor of inductance L, which is under capital L. The EMF applied is imaginary part of that is E is equals to E to the E0 into E to the power j omega t. That is equation number one. The EMF induced across the inductor, that EMF is E is equals to minus L into di by dt. This standard expression of induced EMF across the inductor. This is called equation number two. From equation 1 and 2, we have to find the resultant expression. Before that, this negative sign shows that the EMF induced oppose the change in current. From equation 1 and 2, we have to clear here minus L into di by dt plus E naught e to the power j omega t is always equals to 0. We have to simplify this expression, that L into di by dt is equals to E naught e to the power j omega t. We are in this expression. Now we have to again rearrange this expression. Left hand side we have to take only di, and remaining terms we have to shift toward the right hand side. Then di is equals to E naught upon L into e to the power j omega t into d, isn't it? Now integrate above equation, then what we get? That is the integration. E naught upon L is constant outside the integration. Then what is the integration? The integration of di is I. Integration of di is I. E naught upon L is constant outside the differentiation, outside the integration. The integration of e to the power j omega t into dt is nothing but d e to the power j omega t upon j omega. This is the integration. Then what we write here, that is E naught upon j omega L into e to the power j omega t. This is the integration. But we know the value of j. We have called this equation number 3. Now we know the value of j is cos of pi by 2 plus j into sine of pi by 2. And this is nothing but the e to the power j into pi by 2. That is the value of j. Put this value in equation 3, we get that is I is equals to E naught upon what is the value of j is omega L into what is the value of j? Omega L into j is the e to the power j pi by 2 into e to the power j omega t. Now this is nothing 1 upon j pi by 2. We have to take then simplify this to two exponential term. That I is equals to E naught upon omega L and into take j common j into omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, correct. Now this omega E naught upon omega L is nothing but the I0, that value is called as peak value of current, means this value is nothing but the I naught, means I naught is equals to E naught upon omega L. This is called as peak value of current. This is called as peak value of current. This is called as peak value of current. Now, after that in this peak value of current, that omega L, the term omega L is called as inductive reactance of the inductance. which is denoted by XL, that is XL is equals to omega L. That XL is equals to omega L. Once again, I will repeat here that XL is called as inductive resistance of the inductance, and it is denoted by XL, that X value of XL is omega L, and omega is nothing but the 2 pi F. Then what is the value of XL? That is XL is equals to 2 pi F into L. This is the value of inductive reactance of the inductance. Now, after that, we have to find out the impedance. Impedance is denoted by Z, that Z is equals to E naught upon I naught. That E naught upon what is the value of I naught? We have to take here I naught is nothing but the omega E0 upon omega E0 upon omega L. Yeah. And this is nothing but the E naught not get cancelled, 1 upon omega, 1 upon omega is nothing but the omega L. And this omega L is nothing but the XL. This is the impedance, is nothing but the inductive reactance of the inductance when the pure capacitance of the capacitor is connected across the applied EMF, that EMF, alternating EMF, that E is equals to E naught sine omega T. Okay, thank you.